like my style, don't ya? Nice like this, I wish I was richer. On my turf, roll out the Henry Rux. She like when I hit the receiver. Friend hopping, this is a four-seater. Made a yank straight out the wood, I'm Derek Jeter. Major Liga, no fatiga. We don't get no henna, we don't get no macarinas. Maybe gon' throw your back out, tryna work, you need a breather. I need a break.
Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down with me, down with me? Hold on. Won't you get down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, down with me, down with me, down with me? Oh, you down.
Tell me who you talking to.
Roll up that Sinatra, fly la mama to the moon. She asked me what's my life path. Told her 55 south to the cat. So many couches I crack. Shout out Zozo, Tree Tree, and Shout Classic.
Baby, I know you really wanna be my only one, but I need somebody to hold on to the top of a baby. Baby, I know you really wanna be my only one, but I need somebody to hold on to the top of a baby.
We are sandwiched between Fort Worth and Dallas, Texas, in Arlington at the luxurious AT&T Stadium. A moment ago, here was the scene with the Cowboys emerging from their tunnel. It was loud. It's still loud. We're ready for football as the Cowboys get set to match up with the Cleveland Browns. Which of these 0-3 teams will visit the win column for the first time? We'll see. We're underway here in Week 4. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line.
First and 10. At their own 35-yard line.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards. A tough run by Ezekiel Elliott, the fourth overall pick in the 2016 draft.
If you watched tape of him in college, you saw plenty of those runs because I know the highlights showed him in the open field breaking away from people, but that's how he wore down defenses, those exact type of runs.
First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there, a jumbo package look. They keep on the ground with Elliott. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
On second and 12, Prescott, and he'll lay out. out and pull it in. What a diving catch there.
15 yards on the play, first down.
Every coach we ever talk to says to his team before the game, quick start, guys. Let's get out of the gate fast. How about that? They took his lesson to heart, didn't they?
They did exactly that. A nice diving catch here on the game's opening drive. So a first and 10 upcoming from Browns territory now at the 41. The first carry now for Tony Pollard. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Brings up second and 9 at the 39-yard line.
They stay on the ground, but this time it's Elliott. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down to about the 39. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it.
Brings up third and 8.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. The give is to Elliott. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. Just a gain of 2 there, and it's going to bring out a fourth down.
I know that speed is the hallmark of today's NFL game, but the key to good rushing defense is still having your linebackers set the edge.
A 54-yard attempt.
And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That wasn't more than a foot or so wide to the left. And this will remain a scoreless game.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
So after the missed long field goal attempt, this offense set up nicely at the 44-yard line. They'll run for the first time with Kareem Hunt. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Second and 9 from the 44. His first carry, only a yard on the pickup, and now they've got a third down and 8.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sift through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Yeah, the Cowboys here on third down bringing in an extra defensive back. The shotgun, it's Mayfield. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down.
One thing that you're going to see from this offense is that they love the matchup with their wide receivers against this secondary. That one wasn't successful, but don't expect them to back away from attacking all game long.
They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Prescott from the gun. And his throw here is incomplete.
The rookie CeeDee Lamb, the intended receiver.
And it's third down.
And that throw behind his man, he missed him, incomplete.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. And that will be incomplete.
That certainly looks like nothing to show now from these first two possessions. And guess what? When you're on a losing streak, that can lead to a full sense of, here we go again. So on the sidelines, the offensive play callers, quarterback, they've got to get together and dial something up to start their next drive. Otherwise, it could be a long game.
This will be fielded at the 17. 62 yards on the punt that time. Wow. And the Browns will take over first and 10.
At their own 26-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Mayfield gives this one to Hunt. And to the 42-yard line here and brought down there. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
On the tackle. It's a gain of six.
They go play action. Mayfield. And finding the tight end, Hooper. A gain of six there on first.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
Six yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's second and four. They run from the shotgun with Washington, and he's got this one across midfield into Cowboy territory. A three-yard pickup on second and four. Now they'll need to convert here on third and a little more than a yard.
Brings up
from the gun, Mayfield. And a throw there going to be incomplete. And this is too far behind his man. He missed him. It's incomplete.
Brings up fourth down.
Kevin Stefanski going to take a chance, going for it on fourth. Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. Here's Jamie Gillendale as he'll kick it away for the second time. It's away, and it's a high kick here, but not high enough to hit the scoreboard here in Dallas. It'll go as just a 15-yard punt, and the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10.
At their own 37-yard line.
So Prescott and the Cowboys now with a first and 10 at their own 37. He'll hand it off to Elliott to begin the drive. Elliott a first down and more. And he's going to get this into enemy territory at the 45. The drive starting play, a good one. Give him 19. Relatively small sample size, but that's his longest run of the first quarter. Bounced it out to the outside to make it successful.
And to get there, you actually need some help. It's not just your pure speed getting to the corner, making sure that the blocking is taken care of inside so the pursuit doesn't get you. And oftentimes, those wide receivers, tight ends, it might be flexed out, they've got to control the edge and make sure no one from the outside can spill the play before he gets there.
The escapability in evidence there is that one. Good for 15 and a first.
10-10 at the 29-yard line.
A first down carry by Elliott. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. No score after one on EA Sports. The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Prescott, a quick throw caught by Cooper. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns' 13-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
First and 10.
How about a guy proving his worth in different ways? Had the big play in the run game to play before. This time, they go right back to him in the passing game, and he comes through with yet another big play. That's why you work out so hard in the offseason, so you can stay on the field and accumulate big plays.
Stop made by Myles Garrett.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held them to a gain of two. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and eight. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. From the shotgun again to Elliott. And here he'll get it down to the seven. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave him with a third and about four more for a first.
Brings up third and four.
Get him down about 3 yards short of the first. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down.
Well, this was just simply excellent defense. On this third down, they had to be alert for the possibility of a pass, but that didn't stop them at all from understanding what was going on when they decided to run the football, and they just swarmed and stuffed them for almost no gain.
The move from Mike McCarthy is going to be to keep the offense on the field here on fourth down. They're going for it. Looking to throw. Prescott. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas.
Lamb.
CeeDee Lamb. His third touchdown now on the year. As his guys are first onto the scoreboard here this afternoon. It took a pretty big risk right there, going for it on fourth down. But, hey, not only did they get the first down, forget about that, they got in the end zone.
Yeah, because normally you're just thinking, can I get enough yardage to get it past the sticks and pick up a first down? Instead, they go for the end zone and get it done with no margin for error. Remember, fourth down, they went for it.
And this carries into the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. They've had it twice. They've punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down. How big.
And this is going to be intercepted. Xavier Woods with a pick. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. They're trying to resurrect his confidence. Last week was a disaster. 5 interceptions in that loss, and another pick there.
I played with a quarterback like this before, and he had a tough game. And the head coach said, I'll take him. I'll fix him. The very next game, he started out the exact same way. The head coach turned to the offense coordinator and said, he's yours from now on. Someone has to take responsibility and work with him and try and get him settled.
Second and 12 now at the 44-yard line. Out of the gun, here's Prescott. Got his man there, complete to Gallup. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards.
That's a game. I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
Yeah, he is marked down right about on top of that imaginary yellow line, but they say he's a bit short. They missed a field goal earlier, so possibly as a result, that's why they're going to try to go for it here on fourth down. He may try and run for this. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. They only got a couple, but a couple's all that they needed as they convert on fourth. So first and 10 now from the 30. It'll be a handoff to Pollard. About 3 yards there to the 27.
Number 20.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry.
Second down, Elliott. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. That second down play nets a -4.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
On third down, it's Prescott. Steps away to his left. He's going to fire one, corner of the end zone. The Browns D locked in on third down, brings up fourth.
Early on, the running game's been working well, and the offensive line has been pleased by that. The thought process there, catch those safeties creeping up, trying to help against the running game. They tried to hit them over the top, unsuccessfully.
And the accuracy lacking there for Zuerlein. It's off to the right, no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So it's a rare two-miss ball game for him now. Normally one of the more dependable guys you're going to find around.
Very unlike him. One of the better kickers in the NFL. And I don't think there's anything wrong with him physically or mechanically. He's just having one of those games.
So the missed field goal, and now they're in great shape. They'll start at the 38. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the linebacker, Jalen Smith. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line.
First and 10 at their own 44-yard line.
The Dallas offense here set to begin the drive. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Second down at 4. And we've hit the 2-minute mark in this first half of action.
A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
On second down now, it's Elliott, and he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down. Well, we know he's an electric runner. Earlier this half, you were wondering how they were going to bottle him up at different levels. That was your suggestion. Some mixed results.
Yeah, certainly, because we have seen him bottled up at times. We've seen him playing very well. We've also seen him pop the cork a few times and get out of there, haven't we?
We have indeed. A big play on the catch and run, covering 34 yards.
Oftentimes now, offenses aren't nearly as precise as days gone by. They just tell receivers, find an open patch of grass and let the quarterback find you. And that's exactly what they did on that play. First with the pass through the air, nice chunk of yardage there, and then additional pickup with his legs after the catch.
And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Ezekiel Elliott, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Cowboys will extend their lead. CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Browns take over first down 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Browns drive about to get started. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But there's also something to challenging your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
Down. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. Now the Browns signal for the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
First down.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Working out of the gun, Mayfield, and that'll be incomplete.
It certainly didn't appear that that's where he wanted to go with the ball initially, so he tried to get something out of it by dumping it off to his running back unsuccessfully.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Mayfield, and he completes it to Hunt, and he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there. Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining. They'll throw again. Here's Mayfield. And he's got his man. That's Landry. And he fumbled it. It's on the ground. And it's picked up by the Cowboys. And the return stops just a little bit shy of midfield at the 48-yard line.
We have seen this before, and we know coaches preach about this and work on it all the time. Catch the ball. You know there's going to be some traffic somewhere. They've got to put it away and secure it as they try and get downfield.
Good starting position for the Cowboys here as they come up first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. That one complete, Elliott. And some room to maneuver. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Here's Prescott. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Now a chance to make that big play really hurt. It's first and goal just outside the 5. Prescott. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. Two first half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys will add on to their lead. He was on point throwing the ball right there. He had the big play to get him down close, and then he delivers a touchdown pass on first and goal.
And you mentioned the big play that got them down close. I think that big play left them reeling a little bit. They didn't recover from it. And you know they always talk about having to have a short memory on defense after a big play against you? Looks like their memory was a little too long there.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And this will not be fielded. It's a touchback and comes out to the 25. The Browns drive about to get started. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
14 yards there on the pickup, and it'll move the chains. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report. The Browns going to see the football first, but they trail here as we resume play on EA Sports. Mayfield going to lead the Browns up now, first and 10 at their own 25-yard line. They'll start the third quarter on the ground with Hunt, and he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
On second and 11 now. Mayfield, that one is caught by Hunt. He'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of 6.
Complete to Kareem.
Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down, a nice safe throw and a good one.
He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He was looking for Landry that time, and it's second down.
That's an excellent play by the defender. He diagnosed that one, closed quickly, and helped force the incompletion.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Going to the air again with Mayfield. Gets this to Kareem Hunt, his running back. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
To Kareem Hunt.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down.
Third down.
And it's complete. Hoover. And he's going to have a first down as he's brought down at the 44-yard line.
A gain of 9.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. He's got Hooper on the short connection. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Second and 2.
8 yards on the pickup.
Facing a second and 2 after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. Mayfield tosses one complete to Landry. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 23.
A gain of 12. And the Browns
play action now. Here's Mayfield. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Another nice gain, 16 yards there, and a first down again.
At the 8-yard line.
To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
Jarvis Landry, Pro Bowl wideout, the intended receiver. But it'll be second and goal.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes. But the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
Nothing on first down, so the ball remains at the 8-yard line, second and goal. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Mayfield looks to throw. And he's got it. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Cleveland. Kareem Hunt, his second touchdown on the season. And the Browns make some inroads here on that deficit. And they're able to cut the deficit to 12.
Makes the score Cowboys 19, Browns 7.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. And they will watch this one land in the end zone. That'll be a touchback.
Their own 25-yard line.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Their lead down to 2 scores after the touchdown a moment ago as they start with a first and 10.
Prescott on first down. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
It's now second and 10.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
So following the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 25. They go back to Elliott. He's been busy. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
He can run for it, and he will. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. He has enough for the first down, and the keeper a gain of 6.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Oh, incomplete. A turnover would have really helped there. Almost intercepted. Instead, it's just second down.
And those two just have been in sync thus far. They've done a nice job against him, but still, with his talent, you would expect them to have more completions to him in this game.
Dallas, Texas is the spot, third quarter inside AT&T Stadium. Glad you're with us. Second and 10. Prescott now. Looking deep in the direction of Cooper. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete. Amari Cooper, his intended receiver, third down here.
Third down.
A deep ball down that right sideline.
made sure that he put it where either his guy was going to catch it or no one was.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Throwing, Prescott. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down. And now a timeout called defensively by the Browns. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Out of the gun, it's Elliott. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. They get 10 more there, and I believe that'll be enough for another first down. It will.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive, because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Now Prescott, flush to his right. He'll get 3 yards on the scramble there. It's 2nd down.
He was able to get away earlier in the drive, but apparently all the time they put in practice finally came to the front, didn't it? They remembered their lessons and found a way to contain him when he took off on that one.
Go! Check four, check four! Check nickel, nickel, nickel!
On 2nd down, it's Elliott. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That one good for a 1st down pickup of 18 yards.
Well, this has been a long drive. In fact, it's eaten up a good chunk of the 3rd quarter, which is precisely what you want when you're playing with the lead.
So from inside the 20, here's 1st and 10 at the 18.
Come on, D. Lost 59. Go. Get out there, get out there.
They'll go with Pollard here on 1st down. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last 2 plays. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. So, boy, that's already the 3rd they burn here. They are out of timeouts now before we've even hit the 4th quarter. One man in the backfield, Elliott. It looks like a jumbo set with 3 tight ends here for 1st and goal.
6 guys, check 6 guys.
They'll try to throw now. Prescott toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete. Amari Cooper, the intended target, but it'll be 2nd and goal.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap, and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Second down at 5. A 20th carry here for Elliott. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott. His 2nd touchdown of the afternoon. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
That drive that really increased their cushion felt very military to me. Very precise, methodical, as one of the words you've taught me.
and they just got it done.
And slowly but surely now starting to pull away a little bit. Things looking good for them here in the third quarter.
Not only pulling away, you mentioned that slowly but surely, you also drain clock too with a drive like that. So you really give yourself an advantage.
Missouri line good with a PAT, and that will make this a 19-point game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll just take a seat, and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Browns drive about to get started. They did what they had to do to start this third quarter. Went down, got the touchdown to cut the lead, but the matching touchdown a moment ago, and we're right back where we started at halftime.
Yeah, you're exactly right, partner. They had a little bounce in their step after scoring that first touchdown, but the defense gave one up, and that's the problem right now. Can they get better play from their defense while they continue to score on offense?
That catch good for only a couple.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
Second and 8. From the shotgun, it's Mayfield. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Oh, that's got to frustrate him a little bit because it nearly got to him there, and it would have been the first sack of the game instead. They're able to influence the release, and they did force the incomplete pass.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Mayfield to throw it. And finding the tight end, Hooper. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play. He'll take a shot here for the sideline. It's a big play there for the Browns. And even 40 yards escape. Now Mayfield lost the football. It's picked up by the Cowboys. Through an opening, and there he goes. He's at the 40, 20, 10. And this is going to be brought back for a fumble return touchdown by the Cowboys.
Oh, boy.
How about that for a momentum swing? You had it goal to go. Not only do you cough it up, but they pick it up and return it all the way for a touchdown.
And now you have to give oxygen to the entire team because what a letdown that was. Terrific drive. Looked like you're going to get points. Instead, the other team registers them on the scoreboard.
Zuerlein connects on the extra point. Back now in Arlington, where the fourth quarter will begin with a kickoff following the score on the final play of the third quarter. Now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
I feel like a prince, I feel like a
The Browns drive about to get started. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. Facing a 2nd and 2 after that last catch, good for 8 yards.
At the 43-yard line.
From the gun, Mayfield. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's 3rd down.
And that's one of those plays where it's hard to keep 2 eyes on the football when you know the contact's coming, let alone getting 2 hands around it, hugging it to your body, and absorbing the hit, even for those big tight ends who you would think can absorb that contact.
Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's got the 1st down yardage as he brings this up to the 47. They're able to convert with a gain of 4. First down, Mayfield. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Landry, the intended target, but it's going to be 2nd down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on 1st down. And again, it's Mayfield. And now he'll tuck it and run. The improv act there, good for 9, and now they'll be looking at a 3rd and short, 3rd and 1. The Browns on 3rd down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. They're up against a 3rd and 1 situation. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's going to have the 1st down at about the 38.
It's a gain of 6.
Able to get what they need to keep the drive going with a 6-yard pickup on 3rd down. Here's a throw that's taken in out of the backfield. And he's taken down inside the 30. Right back to him for 10 more and a 1st.
It's a gain of 10.
Well, this game was decided a while ago, and that completion there, it's going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Mayfield now looking to throw on 1st down. And he's got the hook up to Landry.
Mayfield's
pass. It's another 10 yards on that one and another 1st down.
10 yards.
A good position to be in here, 2nd and inches. And Mayfield again with the interception, his 3rd. Picked off by Jordan Lewis. Wow, between last week and this week, that's now 8 interceptions. 5 a week ago, now 3 here.
Well, he is so lucky that one of the defense coordinators I played for, a man named Ken Donahue, is not there right now. Because he saw that happen during his coaching career, and he grabbed the quarterback in the midst of a streak like this and said, "Tell you what, son, why don't you throw it to the defensive guys, and let's see if our receivers can intercept it."
Well, he's got to figure something out because the current formula is not working.
A 3-yard pickup. Brings up 2nd and 7.
Second down and 7. From the shotgun, it's Prescott. Able to hit his target, Lamb. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. A gain there of 21 yards.
1st and 10 at the 30-yard line.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Prescott got his man there, complete to Gallup. No gain there on the completion. 2nd and 10.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Had the completed pass, but for no gain, stopped right at the line, so it's 2nd and 10.
Now Prescott. They'll set up the screen to Elliott. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards there and a first down.
When you have someone throwing it that well, that confidently, you don't have to call the game in fear at all, do you? You just go ahead and play.
Yep, confidence with a lead to throw it here in the fourth, and boom, he's on the money.
Yeah, you don't have to tuck your head in and go like turtle at this point. You can just go ahead and play.
So two first downs, and that moves the ball to the 42 now, first and 10. Prescott yet again. And this is caught by Watkins. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. Three yards remain for second down. Prescott. And he's taken down. This will be a Brown sack. Olivier Vernon. Credit him with a sack as he buries him for a loss of 10.
Enough takes to start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a third and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
They'll need a big play here. Will Dak and the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Prescott from the gun. Eluding the pressure right. And he's able to hook up with Michael Gallup. And they're going to have another first down as he's going to be tackled at the Browns 35. A big play there as they get the conversion on third and 13. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Here's Prescott. And he's going to be brought down here in the backfield. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. Throwing on second and long. Prescott, he'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Trying to bust out of that losing funk, and these fans have to like this. And all right, fellas, this is more like it.
And I know that if this holds up after the game, they're going to give the fans a lot of credit being at home, getting the support. But you and I both know it goes deeper than that. They had to get it together in their own facility. Look each other in the eye and say, okay, what's it going to take to break this losing streak? And they really came together with a good week of practice.
Zuerlein good with a PAT. And the lead will swell by one more. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. So good starting field position for him here as they come up first and 10 at the 41-yard line. To throw, Mayfield. Complete to Washington.
Call it a gain of five. And that'll bring up second down. Second and five after the five-yard completion on first down. Here's a pass swung out left to his running back. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain. Mayfield looks to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that is incomplete.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started. And that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty. And before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Desperation time. Mayfield on fourth down. And this is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And Dallas, they'll take over in terrific field position. After the penalty, it's Elliott. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. It doesn't matter whether you've watched high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get a little greedy, try to get that extra running play in, and it can backfire on them.
Again, it's Elliott. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards the gain there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first.
A gain of two on the play. Brings up third and four. Today's final score, Cowboys 40, Browns 7.
Well, Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Cowboys, it took a few weeks, but they finally get their first win of the season here in week four. And they'll have another home date next week as the New York Giants come to town. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, they'll sink now to 0-4. And they'll have a chance at redemption next week at home against the Indianapolis Colts. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon, saying so long, everybody.